And we're back. Okay. Back to the shirt. So now I've laid those basic colors in. I'm going to go in with a little white. Lighten this up. Bring the tones down through here. So you see, I just use the Naples as a base. Now go back in with a smaller brush. I'm going to return these tones in here. But I want to keep it really loose, by the way, because, again, where's the focus? Focus is on the face. So this is going to be, I'm just kind of blending in a little bit of burnt umber with the Naples. Okay, so now I'm gonna really put some, because that collar is the brightest part of the shirt. So I'm really gonna brighten that up a lot. Now go back in and tone some of this down. But right now, let's really get that brightness in there. And it comes back behind the tie. And then there's a little bit darker. And even though I'm using yellows and blues and browns, the shirt is still going to read as a white shirt. Especially when I add the gray tones on the other side. I'm going to tone this down just a bit. Another thing is, a lot of the time when I'm painting, I'm squinting. It helps me to kind of be more objective. I guess that would be a good way of putting it. Not let my brain take over quite so much and just let my eyes do the work. The old brain still likes to stick its nose into stuff, and it's irritating. That's how we get eyes that are too high or too close together, whatever, because the brain goes, ugh, this is where this is. Like, no, it's not. So I toned that little thing down quite a bit. And this one, I think it needs to be toned down some too. Just a wee bit. Really dark line there, and maybe a little bit like right there. Yeah, there we go. And I'm going to throw in a light. I did try kind of change the shape of that collar. It wasn't on purpose, but it's okay. It still reads as a collar and not a messed up one. I do see where I need to add something though, because this kind of comes over there. And when I color in that tie, this is going to make more sense right here. And now I'm going to soften it. I don't want it to be so liney. I want it to feel like it's following the contours of her neck. So we know that the neck comes around, then goes in, and then goes around. There. Okay. I'm gonna kind of soften that. There. Okay. I'm gonna leave that as it is. I might put some more black up there to sharpen that shoulder, but I'm gonna leave it. Okay. Now we're gonna do the other side of the shirt, which should be fun. I'm gonna lay in the darkest color, which I pretty much have right there. And I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna, I really haven't built this. The lightest color makes no sense, right? We generally go from dark to light gradually, but I'm just gonna do it because my brain needs it, and I'm changing the shape of it a little bit as well. That right there is pink. Don't think I'm gonna put that in there. You never know, I might. But it's close to the same color over here, so I'll probably try to match up that a little bit. I still feel like this is a little too flat. Now, I think I will go ahead and put some Naples right there. Just for funsies. I'm going to go to the a mid-tone, which I feel is around here, and it's slightly warm, but I'm going to keep it cool because I really liked, and if in the end I don't like that juxtaposition, I can just change it, but I'm thinking it's going to look kind of cool and not read as a two-tone shirt, but as a shirt that has different lighting on either side. I'm just gonna fill that space in. And see, I put that in too high, didn't I? Okay, I can fix that. I don't have to do an undertone on this one like I did that one because it's already got it. I'm just building up from there. And I'll probably kind of use that as my light mid-tone. So, but I need to go in and lay in that crease. I don't want it to be too black. It's more right about there. Okay. And this is actually more over here. And the majority of the cool side is the mid-tone gray. I've darkened it just a little bit because I want to go lighter. I guess I should have washed my brush. It rough. Now let's throw that tie in and see if it all makes sense. If it doesn't, then we'll regroup. Not a big deal. I don't get attached to it at any point. Maybe a little bit after it's done. Whoops, I guess I shouldn't have brought that black up so high. That's okay. I'll fix it. Sometimes I do like to mix my black with medium, which I didn't just then, because it takes longer to dry than most of the other. Black and white, in my opinion, take longer to dry than the other colors. Go ahead and pull this up under the collar like that. And then I'm going to come back down. I know I'm doing it opposite of picture, but it just happened that way. So the darker side is going. Might not make sense though, but maybe nobody will notice. No, it doesn't look right. Okay. So I'm gonna bring that other side over. It's all right, we're keeping it rough anyway. I wish I'd curled those collars up like they are. Maybe I still can. Okay. I feel like sometimes, I know probably a lot of people laugh at me for saying this, but I think painting is a brave. Activity, because you're putting your soul out there, basically, and you have to be brave. You see something that looks okay, but it doesn't look perfect or like to the level that you want it to look. And you just jump in there, just like I erased her eyes and put new ones in. Just like I'm gonna change the shape of these collars. It's just a little things, but it does take some amount of bravery, I think. See, I just noticed this really nice dark shape here. It lightens, but it kind of feels like it continues up this way. So I just add a tiny bit there. Yeah. It's still not exactly, but I think that it gives that kind of relaxed nuance. I think I'll do the other side too. So how will I do that? I'm gonna bring it out there. I just really like that little speck of blue right there. Now, what do you think? I think I need a little bit more edge here. Maybe I'll put a speck of blue-gray right there too, like it is in the picture. I'll go in and refine the edges of the shoulders. See that? I'm going to paint this at some point. This girl is in Norway right now. She's a friend of mine. And she, this is what the frigid weather did to her hair. Is that not amazing? She said I could paint it. I can't wait. Okay. What am I looking at? Let's add a tiny bit of red to this here. She's got that fabulous eyeshadow on. I don't think I can duplicate it. It's so shimmery. Super subtle. I wasn't going to even try to do this, but why not? That's what this is for, isn't it? To experiment with. And it's just going to be very subtle. I see she's got a tiny little bit down here, but the light's really catching it. So I'm going to add a few little sparkles. Okay. Subtle. Oh, I forgot I still have to do her eyebrows. Sometimes she puts eyeshadow on the tip of her nose. But we're not going to do that here. She puts a little pink eyeshadow right on the tip of her nose so she can look like a kitty cat. It's so cute. On this one. She's got a little highlight right there that makes all the damn difference. Yes. Really gives her that three-dimensional look that got lost in the posterized version. So we can do a little bit over here too. I see something else. It didn't show up on the posterized. But there's just a little bit of tone right here. And I'd had it in there and then I got rid of it because of the posterized thing. But now I see it needs to be there. And I need to have a little tone right there too. Yes. It's working out. Yeah, I never know. I do know that when I paint every day, they work out more frequently. This needs to be softened. Don't want her to look like a caveman. You want that shelf there, but if it's too deep, she looks like a caveman. Now come the eyebrows, and she's got some fabulous eyebrows, but oof, not sure if I can do it. So I'm gonna turn it. I may have to wait till it's dry, but let's see if I can very delicately get in there and lay down a few sprigs. Mostly going to worry about the shape of them. I wish I had eyebrows like that. And so I had dipped it in color, but just then I only dipped it in liquid just to spread this color out without being too like up a little more color. Don't want it to look too heavy-handed or ham-fisted, as one of my teachers used to say when he would look at my work. It just amazes me, some of the things that teachers say to students that are so discouraging. It didn't stop me, though. It did stick in my head. Okay. That's passable. Okay. Now let's get this signed. That's a wild one. Oof. Wonder if she brushed it that way on purpose. I do think her eyebrows are much closer together than I've got them. I probably screwed up in my measurement somewhere. But I'm not going to worry about it. As long as it's believable. And it looks enough like her. She'd probably prefer it that way. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and brighten that brow just a bit. I'm going to kind of pull some of the skin up into the eyebrows of it. It looks more natural. Okay, I'll do that on this side too. Shimmer. See, I'm wiping my brush, but I'm not picking up any more color. This is where I'm pushing the paint around just a little bit. I do feel like her eyes are a little bit too far apart. But that's just tough titty. This is as far as I'm going with it. Because it is just an experiment. And if you'll notice, I put a tiny bit of green tone there because she has that. She has some blue up in here as well, but I'm not going to get too heavy-handed with that. Maybe I'll put just a little bit up there. I'm going to go in and add some bright lights right on the tip of her nose. You may not see them, but it adds, even if it's not really there, it adds a little bit of sparkle. I think there's a little bit right there too. And now I want to add a little more light to her eyes. These are the very last things we do. I'm going to turn her aside again. And she has a whole line of light across here. I'm going to pull it into the whites a little bit to make them look ultra wet. This is where we take our little bit of artistic license. As long as it makes sense, it's allowable. And one more thing. I did a little line on the water line right there, but I'm gonna brighten it just ever so subtle. You see my tiny brush is already splitting. And I just opened it last night. Okay. They say a painting is never done, but let's say it is. I see problems, but I think in some ways these problems, they can add to a painting. I'll get rid of that little bump. Okay. Oops. I'm not painting her earbud. I think I should paint her nose ring. I think I should. Well, I don't know. I think for now this is fine. I might add it in. I do think I need to darken those nostrils just a hair. Let's see if I can do this without getting paint all over the place. Yeah, they're not exactly the same shape as hers, are they? But that's okay. It's a nose. little bit duller light right here. Okay, I think we can call it done.